We are in the office that was used by Richard Strauss, by Gustav Mahler, by Herbert von Karajan when he was the director. And we are actually on very holy ground in the history of classical music. Maybe I'm a bit of a romantic in that respect when we're talking about masterpieces that have lasted for 200, with all respect to other forms of music that other people may like. But I think that nothing is comparable, really, in terms of influencing civilization, than classical music, and classical music in the best atmosphere. There are many, many professional musicians who, because they're exposed to real sound so many times during the day, that they really don't want to have anything to do with reproduced sound whatsoever. The reason I got involved with Wilson was in the late 80s. I got bought my first pair myself of Wilson Hot Puppies. Well, just after Thomas Hampson, my good friend, had recorded with Leonard Bernstein the Mahler songs. After we had made those recordings with Leonard Bernstein in the great Musikverein, I called Tom over and I said, "Tom, I want you to listen to something. I want you to listen to your voice right now being played through these speakers that I've just got, the Wilson speakers." It took 10 seconds for Tom, or even less, to realize what I had realized. Wilson was a totally different world. It was a completely different world. It was the actual sound of the whole. It was his voice, the harmonics, the texture of his voice, the structure. All of these other speakers, manufacturers, were really to be, and you know, perhaps, you know, maybe we're very emotional people in music, maybe we say exactly what we feel very clearly, but Tom was also, it's a crude instrument by comparison. We literally, Tom said, got to have them, you know, just like you, Peter, got to have them immediately. After we did that, and you know, we bought Wilson speakers, I decided that I must really meet the people behind this product. And they were invited to come to Vienna. They began coming and listening then to really getting into that source of energy and seeing what those composers had in their minds when they conceived these pieces. And then, as we moved through the various designs, I have seen the results in every design that has followed. The speakers, to me, even though I have the greatest orchestras and the greatest singers at my fingertips every day, the speakers, to me, in my private moments at home, are a monument to great musical taste and a monument to the art of music.